Hey guys, it's Roxy here and welcome back to my channel. Today we are playing Hogwarts Legacy. Now, last video, we actually were going through quite a bit of stuff. So we saved a dragon, a Haridim Black, with Poppy Sweetings, and then we got its egg. I also ran some little errands here and there, found one astronomy table, did a Merlin trial as well. So there's a little bit of that in this, but Fire and Vice was our main thing. Then after that, because it's part of the main quest, we have more quests from everybody else, right? So next one is complete Professor Weasley's assignment, which I should, because it's part of the main quest, right? And then I've got Sebastian's stuff. Okay, all these are relationship quests. So Sebastian's stuff, Mum's the Word, Natty's stuff. And then the dragon debrief with Poppy, and I've got extra like side quests along the way. So what are my options, right? And I have a lot of other stuff along the way to pick up as well. Okay, I think I'll go for a dragon debrief first because it is right in front of where I'm standing, which is here, right? Oh, here actually. And then we have another side quest called Venomous Revenge. And then I have this one called Take the Biscuit. And I have another one to call Spot Removal, basically. I kinda need to go to... Oh, actually I need to go to Brood and Pet, not the other one, but... Hey, I might as well pick them all up while I'm at it as well, right? After all, it is part of the gameplay. Okay, so let's do Poppy stuff first.
Over here.
Like us not standing around is inconsistent.
This is a change of pace from our last outing. Don't remind me. The thought of that tent still makes my blood boil. I've been thinking about those poor dragons in the fighting room. The collars they were wearing, they appeared to be goblin silver. I think a collar is precisely what we found at that poacher camp. I've never known poachers to use anything like that before.
The dragon that attacked my carriage was wearing a collar. And Professor Fig was genuinely baffled by its behaviour.
That attack always did strike me as a little strange, seemingly coming out of nowhere. Surely you aren't suggesting that the collars somehow control the poor creatures?
I think
so. Exactly.
Merlin, I don't think the dragon we set free was wearing a collar, but we should check. And if we can find her, we can return her egg.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, I don't want to be keeping a baby dragon. I can't.
I'll start looking into it right away. There was something else that I wanted to discuss with you. I didn't want to press it before. It seems I may have caused you more trouble with Victor Rookwood. Why is he after you?
I didn't tell her. I thought I did.
Rookwood is working with Ranrok. And Ranrok is after something I found at Gringotts. Fig had a portkey that led us there after the dragon attack. It's a bit of a long story, and Fig had asked.
Well, I told Sebastian, and Natty knows about it, so now Poppy has to know about it.
That certainly helps to shed light on what we saw at the tent. Don't worry, I'll guard your secret as if it were my own.
Yeah.
I shan't press for more details. In fact, I should probably be going. I'd like to track that dragon down as soon as I can.
I guess we
I'll
should.
Let you know when I have news of her location.
Great. Nope. There is someone else I'm supposed to talk to here, but he could be upstairs. Serona, she's not around. Huh. Okay, maybe behind. Yeah, this
I'll
stuff.
Fix him. A charm grinder.
Ackley Barnes?
Sir, is everything all right?
How kind of you to ask. The name's Ackley Barnes. And no, it is not. I'm plotting a sort of revenge against my ex-business partner, a conniving fiend by the name of Alfred Lawley.
Oh God, why am
he
I involved in business?
He cut me out of our
politics?
Herbology supply business, just as we were getting started. said I was too volatile to work with. I'll show him volatile.
Well,
I can see why he said that. You do seem angry.
Of course I'm angry now, in large part due to his absurd overreaction to what is simply passion for my work. Supercilious fool, he's passionate about things too, as I intend to remind him by relieving him of his prized possession.
Oh?
A venomous tentacular he's grown from a seedling that was to be the keystone of our business venture. I can't get anywhere near it with Ruth Singer watching me like an augury. Lawley's doing, no doubt. But no one would suspect a student. How would you feel about committing some grand plant larceny?
Okay, this adult is weird as heck. Because I be honest, no adult will be asking, no normal adult will be asking a kid to commit a crime. Okay? People who do that are crazy. Okay, they're not normal. They're like fiends of our society, I guess. So, doesn't make sense. Why are you asking me to do it? Oh, God. Okay, never mind.
You said Mr. Lawley was your ex-business partner. What were you working on?
I had an idea to train venomous tentacular. Create guard plants, if you will, that attacked when ordered. We hit a snag when one ate Lawley's measle. After that, he cut me out of the business, the short-sighted fiend.
Well, if someone ate my cat, I'll be mad.
Why do you need Mr. Lawley's venomous tentacular in particular?
Simple. If I have it, then Lawley
doesn't.
Oh, he's
petty as heck.
Ergo, I can launch my business, and he must start all over again. I'm killing two snidgets with one stone.
This man is so petty. Girls, when you find a boy, a man, don't ever find that, okay? Petty as heck.
What else is in Mr. Lawley's cellar?
All of Lawley's herbology supplies. He has quite the collection.
Why are we burgering
Lawley? Fill your pockets while you're there. Or to slow him down for a bit. And I can get my business going minus any competition.
Okay, I'm going to do it. Although I'm not comfortable with it. But I'm going to make him pay for it. One way or another.
I'll get the venomous tentacular for you.
Marvellous. I know a fellow seeker of
justice
when I see
guys.
One.
This is a crazy
Take as many
fella.
Herbology supplies as you like while you're in his cellar. All I ask is that you bring me the venomous tentacular.
This is madness.
Remember, I just need that venomous tentacular.
Yeah, you crazy, sir. Oh, and it's nearby. let's pick up the other quest while we're at it.
Seems I need to find Mr. Lawley's cellar.
Yeah. I really want to do the Venomous Revenge quest, right? Simply to make the other guy pay, because he's petty. So freaking petty.
What do I do without her?
Oh no, are you okay, goblin friend?
Hello, is something the matter?
Most decidedly, yes. My precious mooncalf, Biscuit, was abducted by poachers up north.
No, I will help you, bro.
I tried to fight back, but I was no match for them.
I'll get her
for you. I'm sorry about your mooncalf, Mr...
Garnuff. Just Garnuff. I'm only one goblin. Not a particularly brave one at that.
It's fine, dude.
I have no chance against a pack of bloodthirsty poachers.
Oh,
my poor Biscuit. I can only hope she's able to escape.
Now this is a quest I want to do.
Why do you suppose the poachers took Biscuit?
I have no idea. Mooncalf dung's highly valuable for fertilizing magical plants. I cannot imagine poachers care much about gardening. Who knows what they'll do to her? She could be flogged, skinned, gutted, and stuffed. I assume. Oh, Biscuit.
I'm going to get your pet back for you, sir.
A mooncalf is an unusual pet. Why did you choose Biscuit?
She followed me one evening. Wouldn't leave my side. Never thought I was one for a pet of any kind. Now I can't imagine life without her.
Yeah, I'll get you back.
Mooncalves are often thought of as silly, simple-minded creatures. But I've seen great depth of character in Biscuit. I wouldn't trade her for a hippogriff or a hippopotamus, or even a goose that lays golden eggs.
Okay,
I'll keep an eye out for your mooncalf, Garneth.
How kind. If only all of Wizard Kine was as gracious to goblins.
Well, if only all if goblins weren't as crazy as Renrock.
Safely home to me.
But I'm sure he's
I promise to reward you for your efforts.
Aw, you don't need a reward, sir. You're kind.
Do keep an eye out for
her. I like.
And be careful out there. Poachers are an unscrupulous lot.
I should try and rescue Garnoth's mooncalf. Sounds as if I'd need to head north to find those poachers.
Okay, I need to meet the last guy for the quest. Then... is this where it's supposed to go? Nope. There's one more quest. Here. And then after that, I need to head over. I can't believe I have to run because no mounts and brooms are allowed. Wow, nice painting, lady. Who's this redheaded?
Hello, is there something I can help you with? How do you do?
I love
I'm Saccharissa Tugwood, and I have an exciting business proposition for you. Now, it may surprise you to learn that someone of my obvious esteemed lineage would be in business.
Oh.
But... I only want to help the less fortunate.
How genuinely
That's incredibly nice of you. Oh, there's more. You see, I've been experimenting with a new beauty cream. A cream that will rid our glorious school of hideous greasy pustules plaguing our poor pubescent classmates. But I've run out of the key ingredient, Boobatuba pus. Boobatubas do grow in the Forbidden Forest, however. If only I could pay someone to collect a few for me.
I love your hair, but it doesn't look real. On the other hand, why are you so mean to our schoolmates? Everybody's in puberty, man.
What precisely are boobatubers? Disgusting things, really. Covered in protrusions. One needs to squeeze them to collect
the pus. On the other hand, my hair couldn't look like that as well.
They smell simply awful and seem to move on their own. Ugh. I wouldn't go near the things if it weren't for my devotion to my classmates.
Wow.
How on earth did you discover that boobatuba pus clears one's skin?
One cannot rely on spells for all appearance enhancements. The errant cast, for example, could relocate one's eyebrows entirely rather than merely thinning them.
Oh, I wouldn't even do that,
My darling and now perpetually surprised-looking neighbour discovered that on her own. Poor thing. I am convinced that beauty potions are the future. I'm forever looking for ways to make this world a more beautiful place. I suspected that if pure boobatuba pus could cause boils, an altered form would likely reverse such abominations. And I was correct.
I can try and find some for you if I have the time.
Marvellous. I'd go myself, but I don't want to.
What
I only need a few boobatubas, but they grow wild, so you'll have to look around.
Okay, sure. Okay, first one. First one
classmate.
We're doing. The mooncalf. The mooncalf. Oh, wait. I gotta get here. I'm sorry, guys. I thought I'd be doing the mooncalf.
So you mustn't tarry.
So condescending.
Into the Forbidden Forest for boobatubers. I hope it's worth the risk.
Well, make her pay for it. Can't be a supplier without collecting money, can you? Okay, I gotta sell the two nifflers. Two cute-ass nifflers. Wish I didn't have to. But then again,
come
life
in.
Is what it is.
Sorry if there's a smell. New batch of toad hide.
The horns are the same.
I'll not mind seeing you here again. Consider yourself welcome.
Very nice. Okay, now to get a mooncalf. The mooncalf is the most important thing. Not letting down my goblin friend. Even though I should be doing other stuff. Okay, let's go there. I was gonna do a big quest today, but it seems like quests. Just to, you know, solve the problems. Unless saving the Mooncalf turns into a big one. Then I'll be like, oh.
This place has seen better days. This is where Sakurissa said to go.
Wait, I'm not trying to find the booba tubers. That's not my main aim. I'm here to tick Biscuit. Biscuit is number one. Ah, here it is. Okay. We head there. That's more important. I'm gonna save that Mooncalf. Goblin friend.
Poachers! Garnet was right then. I'd better be careful.
I know you're
bringing
it! Retreat! I shall kill you for this when I get down.
These
better
be a beast.
Incendio. Inferiamus. Confringo.
Don't go down easy.
Eat my dust. Ooh. How dare you steal my friend, Mooncalf! Well, I had to use Crucio, but on all these guys that... Well, I guess the job done easily. I'll admit that. Even if by right we're not supposed to use it. Glad we managed to get Biscuit.
Now then, which one of you is Biscuit?
Oh god.
Levioso! Arrest him a minute!
Oh, I forgot to change the bag.
Levioso!
Okay.
All right,
I got this.
Let's get you back to Garnet, shall we? Revelio.
Well, the rest of you Mooncalfs can enjoy yourself. I got Biscuit and that's all I need. Okay, great. Time to return to Garnet. Who's in Hogsmeade? why did I press that? I'm sorry, guys. And then time to, like, I don't know, get the venomous tentacular. And maybe I wouldn't give it to him. Just so he's petty as heck. I'm not gonna give it to him. No way.
Oh, my dear Biscuit.
Come here.
Garneth, I've rescued Biscuit.
You have? Oh, is she hurt? Was she frightened? Are you all right?
I'm fine.
Biscuit is fine, as am I. I was able to rescue her without much incident.
Oh, mercy. Where poachers are concerned, I tend to expect the worst.
Oh, it's okay.
I cannot wait to get her home. I so miss seeing her dance in the evenings. Such joy.
I'm I'll glad give it to she's him. Safe now. For I'm free. Sure she'll be happy to go home.
Oh, that is a great weight off my mind. Oh, my sweet little Biscuit. My wise, noble moon calf. And here is your reward, of course. Well deserved. Okay. As I said before, you have restored my faith in wizardkind. You've restored at least a modicum of my faith in wizardkind.
Aww.
Biscuit and I can't thank you enough.
I'm glad Biscuit's going home. I hope I don't have her in my inventory. That would be terrible. I'm glad I don't. Okay, next quest. Venomous Tentacular. Side quest today, it seems. Glad to be helping this Garneth with Biscuit. I think that's a big quest for me. He's such a nice guy. Not like the other two, like, one girl who's like crazy and the other guy is petty as heck. Oh, I might need the disillusionment charm.
This must be the cellar. Now. It's tentacular.
God. Is that Mr. Lolly?
Better not let Mr. Lolly see me.
How am I supposed to get around this without Mr. Lolly sensing me? He's already sensed me like 3 times.
Rosalia.
Stop! Bandit!
I failed this one. Oh god. No, we'll try again. There's gotta be a way to, you know, like, get him to move around. Maybe I can't walk.
To find that venomous tentacular.
I will need to, like, sort of,
Rosalia.
You know, cast things around, I guess.
Better not let Mr. Lolly see me. Rosalia.
were backed into a corner by Mr. Lolly. I hate sneaking around quests. They're one of the hardest.
Where is that venomous tentacula? Revelio.
I have this feeling that I might need to walk out the other way, which is annoying as heck. Am I supposed to fight all these? Mandrakes, got mandrakes, my favorite plant. Well, this is... oh, should have taken all of that. I'm sorry, Mr. Lolly. I should have just taken the plant.
Now that I have the venomous tentacula, I should return to Mr. Barnes.
I should have taken Mr. Lolly's stuff. I'm sorry, sir. I'm a terrible person. I hope you can forgive a student like me. Okay, there he is. Oh, I've taken so much of Mr. Lolly's stuff. I feel so bad. Because I wasn't going to give the venomous tentacula to the other guy as well. If I had a choice. Oh well, I guess both of them can, you know, be petty with each other. Either I'm going to make Mr. Barnes pay, or I'm not going to give it to him.
Completed that errand?
Hello, Mr. Barnes. I have that venomous tentacula.
Huh. Wish I could see Lawley's face when he realizes his prized possession is gone.
Petty.
Let's see who's volatile now.
Let's see both
well
of you
done.
Volatile now.
I'll take it off your hands now.
Oh, I need to be... okay, so I either way, I'm giving it to him. But one is I'll be paid and one is I'll get rid of it. So I like to be paid because he's petty as hell.
It wasn't as easy to come by as I had expected. I'd like to be paid for my troubles.
Only fair, I suppose. I can respect your business acumen. Here's a little something for your next trip to Zonko's. Thank you again for your help. I suspect you have a bright future.
Ugh, this petty man. So annoying. Okay, let's find some legit stuff to do. Like maybe Professor Weasley's quest, because it's the main quest. Right? Not doing this one. I'm gonna do Professor Weasley's quest. Okay, where's the underground harbor? And the field guide from the book in immediate transfiguration in the library. So what's in the library? One is in the harbor. I think they're both in Hogwarts. No idea where she's sending me to. Oh, could we? Do we have to sneak in a restricted section again? Like, that's not what I'm asking.
Revelio.
Here it is. Hogwarts really does have a lot of secret places to go. I would need to prepare the Accio spell. Like, I'm pretty sure I would need to prepare that.
So this is the underground harbor.
Yeah.
Revelio.
Huh. Seems I got it, I think. Let's try and get... Oh. I'm not tossing rocks again. No way. Oh, this thing needs to not see me. Very well.
Revelio.
I guess I'm done. Okay, and then the library. I think the library one would have been harder. Okay, now the library. That's where I'm supposed to go. What is this other side quest? Beating a curse. Oh, Samantha dear. Okay, Samantha. Interesting girl. Fair enough.
That book Professor Weasley asked me to find should be around here somewhere.
Looking for the book Intermediate Transfiguration?
Yes.
Professor Weasley asked me to get something from that book. May I have it?
Did she now? I'll give you this book if you humor me by answering a few questions from my quiz.
Oh, what a Ravenclaw. Quiz.
Some people call bits of knowledge trivia. I would argue that no knowledge is trivial.
That's
Hence,
true.
I have created a small quiz, just for fun, focusing mainly on the lore of the Wizarding World.
Oh,
none of the other
this
students
like the
will
Easter
try it,
egg.
No matter how many times I ask. They all say they have enough with schoolwork. Ugh, they don't value knowledge the way I do. Surely you're interested. I'll even start you off with a few of my easiest questions.
I love. Okay. I like this one because it's kind of like how much of a Harry Potter fan you are, you know. Kind of
a quiz
like
sounds like fun.
True to
Splendid.
Game.
Just a few questions and then I'll hand over this book. Let us begin.
Sure.
Before the invention of the Golden Snitch, which magical creature was used in a game of Quidditch?
Oh, God. Which one do you think it is? I don't know, I'll be honest. So I'm going to go with Golden Snitch. Because the word the Golden Snitch sounds like the Golden Snitch. And more than the Golden Snuggery. And I guess the Golden Snitch has that name that comes from, right? So it's got to be number two.
The Golden Snitch.
Correct! The Snidget was first introduced to Quidditch in 1269 by a wizard named Barbarous Bragg. Sadly, they're thought to be extinct. Next question. Which potion is commonly referred to as liquid luck?
Felix Felicis. I can't pronounce it, but yeah, Felix Felicis. Felicis. Okay, guys. We need to work on that.
Felix Felicis.
Oh,
well
got it.
Done.
Felix
Since
Felicis.
It makes the drinker temporarily lucky, Felix Felicis is a banned substance in all organized competitions.
Mm-hmm.
The tale of the three brothers involves which magical artifact?
Oh, I love. The Deathly Hallows.
The Deathly Hallows.
Correct.
This is like the
According
game quizzing
Beedle the Bard,
you know, Harry Potter
The
fan.
Deathly Hallows consists of the Elder Wand, the Resurrection Stone, and the Cloak of Invisibility. Which ball in Quidditch is the largest?
Okay. There is the Quaffle, the Bludgers, and the Snitch. The Snitch is the smallest. The Bludgers are used to hit people off. And I think the Quaffle is the biggest, so I'm going to go with that.
The Quaffle.
That's right. When a chaser throws the Quaffle through one of three hoops in a Quidditch match, their team is awarded 10 points. True or false? Polyjuice potion allows the drinker to change species.
False. Because Hermione drank cat hair polyjuice and she ended up weird.
False.
Correct. While polyjuice potion can be used to change things such as age or race, it cannot be used to change species. Well, I suppose this has gone on long enough. I'll put the book back on the pedestal now. If you're inclined to test your knowledge again, I have plenty more questions I could ask
you. I love
And
this.
I won't be giving you any more easy questions either. The next ones will be more difficult.
Well, let's see.
I'd like to answer more questions.
What governmental body directly preceded the Ministry of Magic?
This is hard. I actually don't know this. Let's go with International Confederation of Wizards.
The International Confederation of Wizards.
No, that's incorrect. The answer was the Wizards' Council.
Ah.
The Wizards' Council disbanded in 1707 after the creation of the International Statute of Wizarding Secrecy, which required a more structured government to support its enforcement.
So interesting.
Which dragon breed is the smallest?
It's the smallest. I think it's the Peruvian Viper Tooth.
The Peruvian Viper Tooth.
Brilliant! Though the viper tooth is the smallest breed, averaging at around 15 feet in length,
yeah, but it's poisonous.
It is also the fastest breed and feared for its venomous fangs. Who founded the village of Hogsmeade?
Good point. It must be Quincy Hogg, because Hogsmeade, you know.
Quincy Hogg?
No, the answer was Hengist of Woodcroft.
Oh, I just saw
it
his stuff.
It is believed that Hengist used the Three Broomsticks Inn as his home. The hide behind was accidentally created by crossbreeding a ghoul with what other magical creature?
A ghoul and a hide behind? Okay, of all three, I only know the demiguise. So we'll go
a demiguise.
Yes! While the Hidebind has the power of invisibility, those who have seen it have described it as a tall, thin monkey with silver hair. What is the only spell known to repel a Lethifold?
I've no idea. What's a Lethifold? It's not the Patronus charm, so it must be a Knockback Jinx's stunning spell. I think I'll go with Knockback Jinx. Repel, you see.
The Knockback Jinx.
Actually, the answer was the Patronus charm. The only known survivor of a Lethifold attack was a wizard named Flavius Belby, who was on holiday in Papua New Guinea at the time. Who published the law of elemental transfiguration?
Wow, I have no idea, girl. Okay, we're gonna go with the oldest looking name, so that'll be the last one.
Lavender Montmorency.
That's incorrect. The answer I was looking for was Gamp. One of the principal exceptions to Gamp's law is that food cannot be conjured, though it can be summoned.
Oh.
What does the Hogwarts motto translate to?
Never tickle a sleeping dragon. This people should know.
Never tickle a sleeping dragon.
Correct. In Latin, the Hogwarts motto is Draco Dormiens Nunquam Titillandus. Which magical creature is the only one known to produce eggs through its mouth?
Eggs through its mouth? The Ashwinders? That's where there are lots of eggs all over.
The Ashwinder.
That's incorrect.
Oh.
The correct answer was the Rune's Paw.
She looks...
According to Parselmouse,
she hates me more.
Each of the Rune's Paw's three heads serves a different function. The left head is the planner, the middle is the dreamer, and the right is the critic.
Ah.
Where is Ilvermorny's school of witchcraft and wizardry located?
Even though I'm not doing well, I learn a lot of things from her, which is great. Oh, Ilvermorny. I'm not exactly sure, but I know it's in America, so it's not the Amazon rainforest. It's either Pyrenees or the Mountain Greylocks. We'll go to Pyrenees.
The Pyrenees.
No. Ilvermorny is actually located on Mount Greylock. The American school was founded in the 17th century by Iseult Sayre and James Stewart. What is the most powerful love potion known to wizard kind?
Amorentia.
Amortentia.
Oh, I pronounced that wrongly.
That's the answer. Amortentia smells differently to every person, according to what they find attractive, such as dusty book covers or...
That's what it is to her?
Are you interested in continuing on to the next round? They're my most difficult questions.
No, girl, I can't do it.
I don't have time for another quiz at the moment.
That's fine. Come and find me if you'd like to try later.
Sure. Just not now.
I put the book back on the pedestal for you.
Velia ought to make quick work of this. Professor Weasley's tasks are complete. I should attend Transfiguration.
Yep. Where is Transfiguration? Is it here? No. Transfiguration classroom. Well, that was a lot of hard stuff. But I'm actually learning things about the kid I don't know. So that's really cool. Because I guess that's what all Ravenclaws love to do. We're alone know-it-alls that love to know more. It's annoying, I know.
I heard Professor Weasley transfigured the book with all her test answers into an owl.
Taking
owls
are literally if you ask me.
She's not an animagus, right?
Oh, hello.
Yeah, she's not.
Goodness. Settle down, settle down. Transfiguration, as you may be weary of hearing me say, is an exact science that can take a lifetime to master. But we needn't be daunted. Almost anything can be transformed if you can just perceive the potential within it. As I see in all of you, tremendous witches and wizards, every one of you. Or it could just be my eyesight. Now, you all know what to do.
I don't actually, but oh well, okay. Guess we learned the Transfiguration spell. Can I transfigure my enemies? That would be pretty cool, right?
Beautifully done. Class is dismissed, and remember, now is not the time to ease off your studying.
Okay, let's try.
I haven't been called Puffskeen Dunking once since you brought me that venomous tentacular leaf. I think I am at...
Uncle Roland sends his best. He often asks...
You wanted to discuss my progress so far this term, Professor.
I did. You seem to have had no trouble in getting up to speed. And frankly, excelling in your schoolwork this year.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you, Professor. The extra assignments have been helpful.
As I suspected they would be. Now, it seems you've been making good use of the opportunities presented by your field guide. Of course, the guide isn't the only measure of success. Deke tells me you captured a unicorn and brought it back to the Room of Requirement. Protecting so rare a beast is an accomplishment of which you can be quite proud. This.
Thank you, Professor.
I will say I'm especially impressed with all you've accomplished in light of the rumors of your... extracurricular activities? Was your extended conversation with Mr. Ollivander after you'd obtained your wand, or subsequent search of the owlery, connected in any way to Professor Fig?
Can't really say anything. I don't want to get Professor Fig into trouble, so I'll go say no.
Not at all. I enjoy talking to Mr. Ollivander. I'm fascinated by wand lore, and I'd never visited the owlery. Bit of a mess.
I see. I admire your penchant for learning, but do remember that your classwork and field guide are designed to educate you thoroughly. It'll be the end of the year in no time, and you'll want to be well prepared for your OWLs.
Oh.
I'll provide a final assessment at that time to ensure that you're ready for your exams.
Okay.
Until then, well done. You are dismissed.
Thank
if you wish to practice the spell you just learned, the training dummy is available.
All right, I'll try it.
Maybe only to me could save my uncle's life.
Revelio.
Since our visit to Feldcroft, something dawned on me about the triptych. Meet me at the Overlook, just north of the Forbidden Forest, and I'll explain.
Another idea. I think we may be able to find what we need at a goblin mine south of Hogwarts. Meet me there and bring someone who speaks gobbledygook.
Oh god, who speaks gobbledygook? Armin
speaks something about gobbledygook.
Yeah, he did. He did say he speaks gobbledygook. Well, since I'm sneaking around.
Alohomora.
Looting stuff along the way. Who's Abraham Ronan? I guess I should also be reading these, you know, but... And those will help with, you know, answering the questions that our dear friend will prepare for me. Remember this one? Oh.
Alohomora.
Alright, I hope something good comes out of it. Okay, I remember this one requires a Levioso.
Revelio.
is a little moth here.
Lumos.
Although I'll be honest, I have no idea where this goes. It's gotta be nearby somewhere, right?
Revelio.
Seriously? Cannot go through this? Now I was here the last time round. Where am I going? Is it the Slytherin common house? I'm not very good at Summoner's Court, bro. Like, I'm terrible at it. Am I ever going to reach that thing? No brooms are allowed. Didn't know that worked. Oh no, that's where I got eaten up the last time around. Nope. Got that house token already.
Revelio.
I can't figure out how to get there. Is there
I have some promising news about the location of our Hebridean dragon friend and where to return her you know what. Meet me in the town circle in Hogsmeade.
Been here before, it seems.
Revelio.
Oh, that's the frog choir. This door. Oh well. can't figure it out. Okay, time to regroup at the Room of Requirements first. Okay, let's see. Need to stock up my mandrakes, man. Ran out mandrakes, guys. I wonder if I could, you know. How do I use fertilizer on my mandrakes? What does it do? Oh, increase their yield. Cool. Okay, let's see how many I've got. But 10 Thunderbrew. Okay, never mind. Time to do some housekeeping. Okay, I'll do my housekeeping after, like, you know, on my own. Alright, well guys, let's see the quest first. That's not part of housekeeping. That's part of what we gotta do next. Okay, so next is in the Shadow of the Mine, and it's all gobbledygook, which we need to, you know, speak with Armit about that. And then the other relationship quest would be Poached Eggs, Mom's the Word, and Shadow of Discovery. We suddenly have a lot of quests. Right, so I think the next time round I will have to be doing In the Shadow of the Mines, and it's all gobbledygook. Let's get middle or halfway before we do Mom's the Word, Poached Eggs, or In the Shadow of Discovery. Okay, so if you like my video, please do like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye!